الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من حسن الإسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعني صدق الله العظيم. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has gifted us and He has showered us with many favors. So many favors that if we are to delve inside it, look inside of the favors of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the bounties of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, it is not possible. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala mentions Himself, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا, that if you are to start counting the bounties of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, then you will not be able to do so. It is not in the capacity and it is not in the capability of a human to do so. He will not be able to do too many bounties. Rather, the ulama, they say that there are bounties inside of a bounty. If you are look at the sun and the moon, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, وَالَّذِي جَعْلَ الشَّمْسَ ضِيَاءَ وَالْقَمَرَ نُورًا, that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is He who has made the sun as light for light, and He has put radiance inside of the moon. Different bounties for different things. Not only that, in one bounty, there are so many bounties. So Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has gifted us and showered us with many bounties. One bounty that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has gifted us and to which we are very neglectful towards is the bounty of time. Waqt. To such an extent, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala mentions in the Quran. Now before I go on to the ayat in the Quran that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has mentioned in regards to time, I'll explain to you the importance of time and what Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala does when He wants to show importance to something. When Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala wants to show importance onto something, He takes an oath. So whenever Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has taken qasam, an oath, onto something, that means that thing is very important. It holds great value in the sight of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And not only that, after it, whatever is going to be said is also of great importance. Rather, it would be even more of importance. So if you look in the Quran, in many places Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala does that. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, wal fajr wa layalin ashr, that oath unto fajr, on the time of fajr, on the time between fajr starts, He has taken an oath to show the importance of fajr, the time of fajr before the, not the salah, the salah of fajr is important in itself, but before the time of fajr. And not only that, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, He wants to emphasize something else even more. So wal fajr wa layalin ashr, Allah takes an oath unto fajr and He then says wa layalin ashr, and the 10 nights, in regards to which the mufassirin mentioned the consensus is there's the 10 nights of Dhul-Hijj, the first 10 nights of Dhul-Hijj. So Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala takes an oath, He takes a qasam when there's something important to be told. In other places, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala shows the importance of something. وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has taken oath unto 8 different things. Why? To show the importance of something which is going to come ahead. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا, that person who has done tazkiyah of himself, he is successful. So similarly, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in regards to time, He says, wal asr, oath unto time. Oath unto time. Then on ahead, He says, innal insana lafi khusr. That verily, indeed, there is emphasis inside of this. Innal, inna is used for emphasis. Innal insana, that humankind, insan, is in khasara. He is in a loss. Lafi khusr, innal insan, lafi khusr. In regards to what? What is he in loss in regards to? He is in loss in regards to time. What does that mean? He's in loss in regards to time. My brother, what is time? How valuable is time? Time is life. Time is life. We usually tell somebody who's wasting our time and we need to go to work, the time is money. But time is life. How? Because seconds, because days are made out of hours, hours made out of minutes, minutes made out of seconds. That is why Hassan Basri rahmatullahi alayhi mentions, يا ابن آدم إنما أنت الأيام إذا ذهب يوم ذهب بعضك. That you are only days, merely days. You are made out of days. If a day goes, then part of you has gone. That is why if we are to do anything in the past, we cannot go back and fix it. Them days cannot come back. That is something that has gone, that's it. The only thing we can do is for the future and change for the future. That is why, my brothers, people listening at home, I earnestly request that we take value of the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Every second, every minute, every hour, every day, every month, every year is valuable. And not only that, when a day goes, it is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that one day has gone by from your life and it is a day nearer to your grave. That is why let's value our time, let's use it appropriately, yes, let's use it in useful things. Time is of three categories of things. Three things, amal, we can do, which will pass time. Number one is something that we do, amal we do for the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no better amal than an amal which is in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then opposite that is time used in carrying out actions in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no worse thing than that. But I'd also like you to know of a middle, a grey area towards majority of people are very neglectful towards, and they are not even aware that we are wasting time in something which is of no use in this world nor in the hereafter. That is called la ya'ni, something which is not useful in this world nor the hereafter. Let's look at the past year. It is merely a 1 year where we went into lockdown. 1 year, nearly. Let's look back. Everybody is a judge and jury for themselves. How much have we progressed in deen? Many of us were at home. Many of us were working from home. We had a lot of time which was saved. I knew 10 students last year. Have I moved forward? Have I gone to 11? Have I gone to 12? Have I gone to 13? In 1 year, I had all that time. Every day, I would save 1-2 hours. Because I was not going to work, I was at home. What have I done with them 2 hours? I did not need to wake up so early to go to work. I have saved an hour. So in the morning, for that 1 hour, what have I done? My friends, this is something to contemplate upon, to take account of. What are we doing with our time? Let's look at the pious predecessors. Subhanallah, you look at the lives you read about them, then you say, what sort of people were these people? They were like angels. But my friends, they were insane as well, they were like us as well. Imam Nawawi rahmatullahi alayh, Imam Muslim rahmatullahi alayh, who has written, rather Imam Nawawi rahmatullahi alayh, who has written the commentary to Muslim Sharif, and also he has written Riyadu Salihin, he has compiled Riyadu Salihin, a book of hadith. He only lived till 45. But when they looked at his works, then they say that on a daily basis, it is as if he wrote 4 to 5 pages a day on deen. And what is that? Something minor? No. My friend, when we want to just write an article, it takes us days. This is masail, commentary, fiqh in regards to deen. Ibn Asakir rahmatullahi alayh, he wrote, this is only one part of his work, he wrote a history on Damascus. And how many volumes, my brothers? 80 volumes. And one volume was not of 10 pages, 20 pages, 100 pages. One volume was of hundreds of pages. This is what you call value of time. You might say, okay, Maulana, this was a time of greatness. This was a time where Islam was at its pinnacle. Let's look at our pious predecessor for the last 10, 20, 30, 50 years, 100 years. Let's look at them. I was just reading the other day, Mufti Mahmood al-Hasan Gangohi rahmatullahi alayhi, who was the Grand Mufti of Deoband at one time, and the Khalifa of Hazrat Shaykh Muhammad Zakariya rahmatullahi alayhi. In regards to him, it comes that when he used to go from Gangoh to Saranpur and Saranpur to Gangoh, so people used to ask him, how long would it take you? He says, I don't know the time, but I know this, that I read from 20 to 22 juz. 20 to 22 paras. This is what you call value of time. And today, the biggest thing that wastes our time is in our pockets. Let's reflect. Let's see. How much time have I wasted on YouTube? How much time have I wasted on WhatsApp? Not only that, sometimes you say, okay, I'm not doing any guna on WhatsApp, on YouTube, but it will take you towards it. That's why Hazrat Tanvi rahmatullahi alayhi, he mentions that la ya'ni is something which is not useful in this world and the after, the border of it is guna. So if you have good deeds, this is good deeds. this is bad deeds, and in the middle is la yani, something which is not useful in this world and the hereafter. The border of it is guna. So la yani is here. So it will definitely take you towards guna, towards sin. And do we not see it? We're on WhatsApp, we're doing one thing, thinking, chalo, I'm listening to a bayan, I'm listening to a clip, I'm listening to this, I'm talking to this person. The next thing you know, you end up doing ghibat of somebody. You end up slandering somebody. You end up sending somebody something which is not even true, which is not even authentic. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, min husnil islam al mar'i tarkuhu ma la yani, that the beauty of a person's Islam is that he leaves that which is not beneficial in this world, nor in the hereafter. So let's take heed. Ramadan is coming up. Let's start practicing. Let's start making good intentions. Last year we worried about Taraweeh in Ramadan, your Salah in Ramadan, what we are going to do. It's been 1 year. Let's reflect on the year before. That has passed. Let's change. Let's bring a change into our life. Until when are we going to carry on like this, my brothers? Till when? Is the lockdown and whatever has happened in the past year not an eye-opener for us? Is it not a time to reflect? Have we not seen people, whether they were old or young, healthy or whether they were sick or ill, they have gone from this world. They used to come to the masjid, they were in the first surf, the second surf. They were around us in our work. Allah bought this, Allah is showing us that, oh insan, take heed. It is a time to change. It is a time to bring back change into our life. Allah has showed us that I do not differentiate between young and old, sick and healthy. Whoever it is, when the time comes, I will take it. So what do we have to do, my brothers? What do we have to do? How do we value time? Number one, make a timetable. Daily timetable, make a timetable. These old people, if you see, they have a timetable. They have a set thing, routine. And that's what we need to do. We have to make a routine. We have to make a timetable. That I will wake up at this time. After that, I will do this. I will pray Fajr Salah. After Fajr Salah, I will pray Yasin. I will recite Surah Yasin. If I have to go to work, I'll go to work. Make a timetable. And when you stick to that timetable, you will not waste time. I'm not saying that everything has to be spent in reciting the Quran, in doing the dhikr of Allah. Everybody has duties. By doing that as well, you will get thawab. You will be rewarded. You're going to work, to earn money. With this intention, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also did business. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to also do transaction. With this intention, you will get thawab. Looking after the children, you'll get thawab. So by making a timetable, you not waste it. Secondly, whatever you have fixed, do it on that time. Whatever happens, do it on that time. Number three, stay away from futile activity. Futile activity is something which is not of no use in this world and the hereafter. My friends will be asked about it. Allah will ask the youth, that I gave you youth, how did you spend that youth? I gave you health, how did you spend that health? What answer are we going to give you? We're wasting our time in futile activity. Number four, on a daily basis, do muhasaba. Muhasaba means to take account of what you have done during the day. Hadhrat Mufti Tatu Usmani Sahib Damat Barakatum Aliyah, he mentions that when we were young, We used to hear our father, he's saying, Astaghfirullah, 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 Allahumma laka alhamdu wa laka shukr, Allahumma laka alhamdu wa laka shukr, Allahumma laka alhamdu wa laka shukr. When at night, before he'd retire to bed on his bed, he would sit like this on his bed, he'd put his head down and he'd say istighfar, he'd say shukr, he'd do the shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Mufti Taqi Sahib, Damat Barakatuhum, he asked his father, oh father, what is this? Because they were good talib, they were seekers, not like us. That we don't want to question about anything in regards to deen. They'd ask, I contemplate on whatever I have done during the day. I've done good, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has given me the ability of doing good. I do something which is not supposed to be done, I do istighfar. My friends, if we do this, we take this into our life, then our time will be valuable.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
Thank you. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
الحمد لله القائم على كل نفس بما كسبت الرقيب على كل جارحة بما اجترحت وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء صلى الله عليه وعلى آله سادة الأصفياء وعلى أصحابه قادة الأتقياء أما بعد فإن راح النجاة تدور على الأعمال ولا يعتد بالأعمال إلا بالمواظبة عليها وعلى حقوقها وهو المرابطة ولا يتم هذه المواظبة والمرابطة إلا بإلزام النفس الأعمال أولا وهو المشارطة ثم ملاحظة هذه المشارطة كل وقت ثانية وهو المراقبة ثم الاحتساب على النفس في وقت خاص أنها وفت الشرط أم لا ثالثا وهو المحاسبة ثم علاجها بمشقة تصلحها إذا لم تفي بالشرط رابعا وهو المعاقبة ثم تأديبها بفنون من الوظائف الثقيلة جبرا لما فات منها إذا راها توانت خامسا وهو المجاهدة ثم توبخها والعذل عليها إذ استعصت وحملها على التلافي سادسا وهو المعاتبة ويرجع الجميع إلى عدم إهمالها لحظة فتجمع وتشرد والنصوص مشهونة منه فانظر ما يسرد قال الله تعالى
يعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. وقال تعالى: وأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى. وقال تعالى: ومن أضل ممن اتبع هواه. وعن أسلم أن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه دخل على أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وهو يجبذ لسانه، فقال له عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه: مه غفر الله لك. فقال أبو بكر رضي الله تعالى عنه: إن هذا أوردني الموارد. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: المجاهد من جاهد نفسه. وقال عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه: حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا، وزنوا قبل أن توزنوا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. أستغفر الله ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله، أستعينه وأستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة. من يطيع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك، وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة. اللهم اغفر للعباس ووالده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم، ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم. وخير أمتي قرني، ثم الذين يلونهم، ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين والمسلمات. اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك حسن الختام والعفو ما سلف وكان. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم احفظ الحرمين الشريفين والمسجد الأقصى المبارك، واجعل اللهم آمنة مطمئنة وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم ارزقنا شهادة في سبيلك، واجعل موتنا في بلد حبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون.
أقيموا صفوفكم وتراصوا. Safi Sidi farma lijiye, please straighten the rows and show that your heels are on the line.
Allahu Akbar. حيا رسول الله حيا رسول الله حيا على الفلاح حيا على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
سو صفوفكم وتراصوا الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين الله أكبر سمي الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة والذرية اللهم احي الناس جميعا اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا ربنا تقبل برحمتك يا رب